Hello, my wonderful viewers, welcome back. The issue of the Nigerian Defense Academy, where bandits attacked yesterday, is still on. The major that was abducted, according to the news, is found dead. A bandit had sent him to God for judgment. It's a pity. But this is what this government has created because they had diverted their attention to what their colonial master wants them to do. The colonial master want them to divert all the military equipment, all the military effort into Biafra land, because that is where the resources which they are taking from us, that is where those resources are, and that is where they have interest. So they have moved military men that supposed defend places like Nigerian Defense Academy to the east to go and protect their interest. That is where they are doing training how to kill IPOB, those asking for self-determination. So they've left their places empty in the north, and the bandits are singing hallelujah. So it's what is happening right now. The major himself was found dead. But let's ask ourselves a question. Don't even the military have CCTV camera to monitor the place? They say they have. And what happened? Let me give you the news. Military personnel in charge of CCTV slept off when bandits attacked Defense Academy. So that is the report. So you can hear it now that they slept off. Let me go to the news in full, you know. Personnel monitoring closed circuit television CCTV at the Nigerian Defense Academy were reportedly asleep when bandits attacked the premises on Tuesday, killing two officers. The gunmen invaded the Afaka barracks of the academy around 1 a.m., killing two soldiers identified as Lieutenant Commodore Wola and Flight Lieutenant Okoronkwo, and abducted Major Stephen Datong. So this Datong is the one that is being found dead later. So that is it. We ask ourselves this question: why should the person monitoring the CCTV camera slept off? Is it only one person that's supposed to monitor a situation, a whole area like this, an important area like that? That's to tell you something is fishy, man. So let's go on with the same news. You see, the spokesperson. What the spokesperson have to say? Bashir Jajira, spokesperson for the academy, in a statement said, "The security architecture of the Nigerian Academy, Defense Academy, was compromised early this morning by unknown gunmen who gained access into the residential area with the academy in Afaka. During the unfortunate incident, we lost two personnel and one was abducted." Now look at the news. He said it's unknown gunmen. Unknown gunmen. He doesn't want to say it's bandits anymore. He doesn't want to say it's Boko Haram. From Boko Haram to Fulani herdsmen, from herdsmen they call them bandit, from bandit they call them now unknown gunmen. So that is how they just want to play it down, because it's all of them are in the same game. Don't you understand it? Well, let me continue with the spokesperson. "The academy, in collaboration with the division, the 1st Division Nigerian Army and Air Training Command, as well as other security agencies in Kaduna State, had since commenced pursuit of the unknown gunmen within the general area with a view to tracking them and rescue the abducted personnel. The NDA community and cadres are safe in the academy, We assured the general public that this unknown gunman would soon be apprehended and the abducted personnel rescued. Medicine after death. That is how, because he has found time to compose how he's going to give a press statement. You know, if not that the public saw what happened and then brought this news into social media, and before the public, they would have concocted the story and tell you a different thing. They wouldn't have admitted that this incident happened there. Now, because he has no choice again to concoct any news, that's why he has to bring the news. Now it is called unknown gunmen. They are not this. I hope tomorrow they will not say that it's IPOB and the Eastern Security Network, because they are the ones they term as unknown gunmen. So unknown gunmen is now also operating in Kaduna. Is that what they are telling us? Okay, whichever way, it's up to them. They keep lying to the public, trying to deceive the public, instead of doing the right thing. And the right thing they have to do is to withdraw all those troops they sent to East. I mean, they sent to Biafra land, both in South and Southeast. Send them back to the North to come and face their bandits. That is what they're supposed to do. If not, what is happening? Those bandits will come and possess this NDA and be training their people to fight the Nigerian government. Because they have forgotten where they should place priority to fight the insecurity in the country. So that is it. The major is gone. And before this time, do you know how much they demanded? 200 million naira. Ransom. They demanded. Yes. They contacted ACA, which is what we call NDA, to demand 200 million ransom for the officer. That was what they did. But they have killed the officer. Now this man, they are planning, according to their press news, how they will chase them and this and rescue the officer. When the officer, they've already chopped off his head. Nigeria. Nigerian security architecture. A disgrace. Only in civilians in Southeast. If it's in Southeast now, where this thing happened now, they would have finished the community. Any girl they see, they will arrest. Any person they see, they will kill. Any young man they see, they will kill. That is how they do. But now that it happened in Kaduna, which raid? Where did they raid? Where is their bomb jets fighting, bombing everywhere in Biafra land? Where is it? You cannot find. Because all they are interested in is oil and gas. That oil and gas is going to consume the whole of the North. You watch out. Since they focus their eyes on oil and gas in Biafra land, they focus their eyes on IPOB and Eastern Security Network that is securing our bushes. Their own land will be consumed. Completely. Consumed. They will have no choice. And unfortunately, these just soldiers that we are killed that lost their lives, they are all Christians. But yeah, they want to serve Nigeria. Keep serving Nigeria. Keep serving the terrorist government. That is what you will see. I thank you people for watching. Please don't forget to subscribe before you leave if you are new to my channel. God will bless you as you do so.